I was introduced to Dr. W.E.B. Du Bois, the scholar, the artist, the international activist, at a time when I was attempting to construct myself as a writer, a community worker, and a scholar. And so his example became very important to me, particularly his confidence.
I can do this the more appropriately because I represent that large group of 14 million Americans, one-tenth of the nation, who, in a sense, explain America's pressing problems.
If you want to read something that applies to 1963, go back and get a volume of The Souls of Black Folks by Du Bois, published in 1903.
Du Bois is so important to me because throughout his 95 years, he is a man who is constantly in the act of changing himself as the open reflection of an ever-changing world.
Du Bois said, we always have the double consciousness. We trying to be black, and meanwhile, you got a white ghost hovering over your head that says, if you don't do this, you'll get killed. If you don't do this, you won't get no money. If you don't do this, nobody will think you're smart. You're trying to be black, and the ghost is telling you to be a ghost.
Everyone seems to have their own Du Bois, but the span of his life and the breadth of his work make that inevitable. Just the facts are stunning. He was the first African-American to earn a doctorate from Harvard University, one of the founders of urban sociology. His groundbreaking approach to history writing gave birth to a new school of historians.
Politically, Du Bois's activism always seemed to anticipate struggles that followed. Many of my generation were unaware that his crucial role in the formation of the NAACP, the Pan-African movement, and the efforts to ban nuclear weapons paved the way for our own participation in the civil rights movement and the Vietnam War protests of the 1960s.